And welcome to this time of worship. It is good to be here on this wonderful day and to worship our Lord. I'm Pastor Jeff Nicholas, and joining me this morning as the worship host is my wife, Pastor Jean Nicholas, and our director of music, Mike Mangan, and our organ is Kit Ullman. And so we want to welcome all of you to worship, and also welcome those at Golden Living Center who will be worshiping with us this morning.
And those who are listening on the radio this morning, we'd ask that you please fill out the attendance sheets that are found in your pews and indicate on the back any joys or concerns that you'd like the staff to lift up in prayer. Those may be placed in the offering plate as along with the "You Can Count on Me" slips this morning.
We do have a couple things we want to announce this morning. With the Boy Scouts are actually doing a potato lunch after service, and then they're having an auction with the scouts there. So our fellowship time is going to be held upstairs today, and our table talks that goes on, that half hour conversation in between, will be in room 209 downstairs today.
If you have turkey points that you have received or that you collect from Rechecks Food Pride, if you are willing to turn them into the church office, we can use those to purchase turkeys for the annual Christmas karaoke community dinner. It's early, sorry.
And then next Sunday, after worship, after the second one at 11:15, we will be having a gathering for anyone who's interested in becoming a new member of the church. And then in 2 weeks, after our worship service, and we're saying we're going to start right at 11 o'clock. It's going to be our annual shareholders dinner and auction, and we'll have that done within the hour. And for those that are afraid of missing the kickoff, we'll actually turn it on, and you can watch the kickoff right here in the church. But we'll get you home right away, and so you can watch the kickoff, run home on that first advertisement if you want, and catch the rest of the game. But we'll have that dinner right after the second service in 2 weeks.
Should we join together in our introit, "Forward Through the Ages"? Please stand.
To worship. God, whose steadfast love fills the universe, rejoices in our presence here.
How precious is your steadfast love, O God. People take refuge in the shadow of your wings.
God blesses us with varieties of spiritual gifts and inspires us to use them well.
Your righteousness is like the mountains, O God, and your faithfulness extends to the heavens.
Amen.
Let's join together in our opening song, "The Church's One Foundation."
The Church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation by water. Own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. Elect from every nation, yet one for all the earth. with every grace endued. Mid toil and tribulation and tumult of her war, she waits the consummation of peace forevermore, till with a vision glorious her longing eyes are blessed, and the great church victorious shall be the church at rest.
Amen. Let's please take a moment and greet one another, passing on the peace of Christ. And then you two could go ahead and run up.
Good morning.
How are you? Good morning.
As we prepare to celebrate the saints among us, and as we prepare to celebrate burning the mortgage of this congregation, let us affirm our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Glory be to the
Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
As we gather, I would invite you, if you'd follow along in the words of preparation as we open up with a word of prayer. We bless your holy name, O God, for all your servants who, having finished their course, now rest from their labors. Give us grace to follow the example of their steadfastness and faithfulness to your honor and glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And then if you'll respond with me after these statements. Ever-living God, this day revives us, revives in us memories of loved ones who are no more. What happiness we've shared when they walked among us, and what joy when loving and being loved, we lived our lives together.
Their memory is a blessing forever.
We see them now in the eye of memory, their faults forgiven, their virtues grown larger. So does goodness live and weakness fade from sight. We remember them with gratitude and bless their names.
Their memory is a blessing forever.
We remember those who were part of our congregation and community. To all who cared for us and labored for all people, we pay tribute. May we prove worthy of carrying on the tradition of our faith, for now the task is ours.
Their souls are bound up in ours forever.
We give you thanks that now they live and reign with you. As a great cloud of witnesses, they surround us with their blessings and offer you hymns of praise and thanksgiving.
They are alive forevermore. Amen.
And we take some time during this service to remember those who have gone on before us, as this is our All Saints Day. We remember those who have passed away since last All Saints Day of November 1st of 2014. We remember Earl Wesley Farwell. Geraldine M. Fouts. Edith Barton. Jean Gartsky, Natalie Murphy, Roland R. Passo, Richard L. or Dick Larson, Robert or Bob Gartsky, Betty Sherman, Marion M. Stebbins, Edward Thomas Arters Jr., Joyce Elaine Urbanek, Yvette L. Manti, Earhart I. Probst, Amy Ann Reibel, and Wynette Gellenbeck. We've had others that were remembered this past year, those who are family or friends, those that you have lifted up that you would also like to have remembered. The first list are those that we have had services for and conducted services for them during this past year. And here are other family and friends that you wanted to have remembered. Harvey Ansay, Elaine Beyer, Jane Campbell, Douglas Crandall, Kenneth Crandall, Lucille Crandall, Terry Crandall, John Derivan, Lorraine Derivan, Ruth Ferris, Dolores Glowin, Duane Harmson, Richard Hummel, Daryl Link, Jeff Moore, Mike Schreiner, Sean Schreiner, Roland Swistel, James Spackman, Percival Sprague, Colleen Tenpas. Art Veith. Fred Younger. We've had some other persons who were remembered this past year with gifts, whose names we've not read off yet, and they're on the next sheet. They have the asterisks there, so we want to also remember, in addition to the names we've read, Christopher Caswell, Alice Collins, Claire or Kay Halfman, Stan Kirschbaum Sr., Creighton Millard, Vivian Snyder, Gary Soldner, we've also listed those that had gifts given in memory of altar flowers and radio broadcast during the past year, and we invite you to look at those names as well. And then there are also, of course, several others who are in our hearts, in our thoughts, in our prayers. Let's have a word of prayer together. Gracious and holy God, you have blessed us with all these persons and others that we've named in our hearts before you, who have touched our lives, molded us to be the persons that we are this day. We are so blessed to have had them walk with us in this journey of life. We have learned much about you, your love and your grace, through these wonderful persons who are now at rest with you in your heavenly realm. We give you thanks for the gifts that they blessed us with. We give you thanks for the memories. And we ask that as they watch over us, as that cloud of witnesses now surrounding us, that we may live in a way which will continue to share that love that you have given to each of us, that love of Christ, which you ask to pass from generation to generation, that we may truly express this love and this grace to one another and to those who will come after us. We give you thanks as we remember each of these wonderful, special saints that you placed in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. As we come to time of prayer, we also take a few moments and we lift up some joys and concerns and some other prayers that we'd like remembered this day and this coming week. This morning we had some altar flowers given by Bill and Verna Funke in honor of their 37th wedding anniversary. And so our congratulations to Verna and to Bill.
We also give thanks to Rosemary Coles for sponsoring the radio broadcast in memory of her husband, Maurice.
We have some concerns that we'd like lifted up and remembered this day. Doug Austin is recovering from some surgery this past week and has a couple more procedures to be done during the next week, and so we'd ask some prayers for Doug. And also Carl Nienheis has had some surgery this past week, and so we pray for him as he continues his recovery.
We continue to lift up John and Pat Kirkendall as they deal with a variety of different health issues.
And then we lift up Pat Wiersma, who's going to be having some surgery this coming week on Tuesday. And then Stella Schoenberger is back from her mission trip over in Ethiopia. So we're thankful to have her back and for the blessing that she was able to offer on that trip.
Let us come to God in prayer, first silently and then joining together. Almighty and most gracious God, we gather this day with so great a cloud of witnesses in our midst and in our minds and in our hearts. We thank you for the ways in which you have made your spirit and your wisdom and your strength and your power known to us in and through those we have honored and named this morning. We pray that as we gather as the current community of faith, that you would strengthen and guide us to be your witnesses here and to the ends of the earth. We pray for your continued blessings to be with Verna and Bill as they celebrate 37 years of marriage, and we thank you for the ways they witness to your love to each other and to all of us as they share in ministry. We pray for your blessings to be with Rosemary as she remembers her husband Maurice. We have named many who are recovering and dealing with a variety of illnesses. We ask for your special blessings to be with John and Pat, Carl, Doug, Pat Wiersma, and all those who we name in our hearts before you who are ill this day in body, mind, or spirit. O gracious God, may they know your love and your care in and through those who care for them and care about them. We have celebrated the gift of children in our midst last night, and we know that there are children around the world who are even in our midst here in our community, for whom candy isn't even an option, that they are wondering where their next meal will come from. And we ask that you would lead us and guide us as we celebrate the children in our midst, that we might also be aware of how we might be called to respond to those who are in need, whether it be from fires or floods or hurricanes or simply the causes of poverty that we struggle with daily. Lead us and guide us, O God, we pray in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass amongst us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Let's join together in our song for all the saints, and you can remain seated for this.
For all the saints who from their labors rest, who thee by faith before the world confess. Thy name, O Jesus, be forever blessed. Alleluia, alleluia. Oh, was their rock, their fortress and their might, O Lord, their captain, in the well-fought fight. In the darkness driven one true light. Alleluia, alleluia. O blessed communion, fellowship divine, feebly struggle, they in glory shine. Yet all are one in thee, for all are thine. Alleluia, alleluia.
We gather at this special time to celebrate something that we've been working on for a good number of years. I think the debt that we had started back when the basement was being remodeled. And there were so many things that were done during that time. Afterwards, since that project was done and we hadn't had things paid off, there were things that we needed to do in between time. We had several projects within the church. We purchased a youth ministry center, and we purchased the Change of Heart Ministry Center. And so this will be a great day for us to celebrate.
This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord.
This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven.
Blessed be the Lord. May God's glory fill the whole earth.
And let us join together in our community prayer. Eternal God, let this ministry, which we dedicate to your name, be a place of salvation and grace, where Christians gather together, may worship you in spirit and truth, may learn of you, and may grow together in love. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
1 Corinthians 3, verses 9 through 13. The Apostle Paul said, we are God's servants, working together. You are God's field, God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, I laid a foundation, and someone else is building on it. Each builder must choose with care how to build on it, for no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has been laid. That foundation is Jesus Christ. The work of each builder will become visible, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed and tested concerning the sort of work each has done. Dear friends, our facilities, our church building, youth and Change of Heart Ministry centers are in good condition, and all indebtedness is paid in full on them. Let us dedicate these facilities and rejoice in their holy use.
To the glory of God, who has called us by the grace, to the honor of Jesus Christ, who has loved us and gave himself for us, to the praise of the Holy Spirit, who illumines and sanctifies us.
We dedicate these facilities
for the worship of God in prayer and praise, for the preaching of the everlasting gospel, for the celebration of the holy sacraments. We dedicate these facilities.
For the comfort of all who mourn, for strength to those who are tempted, for light to those who seek the way.
We dedicate these facilities.
For the hallowing of family life, for teaching and guiding the young, for the perfecting of the saints,
we dedicate these facilities.
For the conversion of sinners, for the promotion of righteousness, for the extension of God's reign.
We dedicate these facilities.
In the unity of the faith, in the bond of brotherhood and sisterhood, in love and goodwill to all.
We dedicate these facilities.
In gratitude for the labors of all who love and serve this church, in loving remembrance of those who have finished their course, in the hope of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord,
we dedicate these facilities.
And let us join in our closing prayer. We now, the people of this congregation, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, grateful for our heritage, aware of the sacrifices of our mothers and fathers in the faith, and confessing that apart from us, their work cannot be made perfect, dedicate ourselves anew to the worship and service of Almighty God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And then our leaders who have guided us through this, Barb Campbell is chair of our finance, Cindy Noe is chair of our council, Bob Schiller is chair of the trustees, and Kevin Carnine is chair of the staff parish relations committee. So thank you for all of your good work in this also. Would like to invite the children to come forward for a moment, please. All right. How are you guys today? Wow. Well, you're all looking pretty good today, I can tell you that. You got your Bibles ready for your Sunday school classes? That's good. That is really good. How many went trick-or-treating last night? Wow. Did you get any candy? Who got candy? Oh, lots of it. Wow. You got lots of it too, huh? I know, you got a lot. And you got a lot? Did anyone get any toys? Or mostly candy? All right, who ate all your candy up? Oh, you didn't eat it up yet? Who had some candy? Who had some candy? So who's all sugared up and wired up today? Oh, all right. Good luck, Sunday school teachers. You had some. Okay. Well, today, I have anyone have any leaves out in their front yard? Yeah, you got leaves out there? Well, what does a rake look like? Does it have a handle on it, and then it's got some prongs on it you rake things up with so you can rake up your leaves? Yeah. Well, how about this? Is this a rake?
No.
I thought I'd go rake my yard today.
No.
No, it's got prongs on it.
It's a fork.
So I can just, it's a fork. Well, why can't I rake with it? You eat with it. Are you sure? Oh, it's too small? That would take me a long time to rake my yard with that, wouldn't it? Oh, I need a big version of this. All right, so I need to have the right tool. Well, what am I going to do with this? Can I eat my soup?
No.
Well, why not?
It's
oh, it'll go right through it?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I also have to go out and dig a hole. So I have this.
No.
No? Well, what do I do with this?
You eat with
it. Oh, this is a spoon.
You can eat soup.
I could eat soup with this, but I can't dig a hole with it?
No.
It would take me a long time to dig a hole with it, wouldn't it? But then I wouldn't want to eat soup in it if I dug a hole in it first, right? Oh. So if we're given tools, we have to use them for the right things, right? This is not for raking, it's for?
Eating.
And this is not for shoveling, it's for?
Eating.
And with this one, I can eat soup?
No.
Oh, this one I can eat? Soup. All right.
This is for fish sticks.
Oh, this is for fish sticks. Okay. Picking up food. All right. All right, fish sticks. This could be for potatoes after church. After that, we can go down with the Boy Scouts and eat our potatoes. So, well, we're given tools for the right purpose. If you want to dig a hole, you need a shovel. If you want to rake your leaves, you need a rake. If you want to eat potatoes or fish sticks, you have a fork. If you want to eat soup, you have a spoon. Well, in the same way, God kind of gives each of you gifts too. Some of those are different. Maybe some of you will feel like, I'm a spoon, I'm a fork, I'm a shovel, I'm a rake. There's a lot of things that God gives to you. Maybe you have the gift of, I know how to be kind to somebody else, or I'm really good at doing some reading, so I like to read. Or, I'm really good at remembering things, so you can teach me something and I'll remember. God gives us all kinds of gifts, and they're all different. But we've got to make sure that we use our gifts for the way that God gave them to us. If you are really good at, eating potatoes, but not quite so good at eating soup, then maybe eat potatoes. If you're really good at raking a yard, get out there and rake a yard. If you're good at shoveling, shovel. If you're good at organizing your room, clean up your bedroom. Wouldn't that be great? And if you don't know how, I bet your parents could teach you that one, because some things you can learn. Isn't that a good thing?
Yeah, but whenever you make a mess in your room, you have to clean it
up. Yeah, when you make a mess, you should clean it up. That's really good. Well, let's say a prayer. Gracious God, help us to use all the tools that you give us for the right things. Help us use forks for eating, rakes for raking, spoons for having soup, and shovels for digging holes. You give each of us gifts and blessings too, O God. Help us to use all of these wonderful things you give to us so that we can share your love and grace in Jesus' name. And all God's children said,
Amen.
And if you guys sit right down here, sit right down in those pews, and we're going to have communion here. May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us, Jesus took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood.
By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet.
Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Communion is open to all in the United Methodist Church. You may receive it down the aisle here, or you can have intinction where you dip the bread into the juice right off to the side over here. Thank you. Huh. I received word that we forgot the offering. You can tell where my priorities are. Let's invite our ushers, if we please would, to receive our morning offerings.
Gracious God, we do sing a song of the saints of God this day, faithful and brave and true. For they have toiled and fought and lived and died for our Lord, who they loved and knew. And as we journey through this life, we know that we can meet them in school, at home, where we work. For we are the saints that you call us to be this day, and we offer now a portion of who we are and what we have, so that all may know your love, your mercy, and your grace. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The scripture reading this morning is from Paul's letter to the Colossians, where we read, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen."
And let's bow for just a moment of prayer. Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. We've been talking about taking stock in the church. We've been doing that for the last few weeks as we've looked at the people within the church, as we've assessed our mission, as we've looked at our ministry. And then today, that day when we do take some stock in our church. That might be the last you have to hear that now after today. I love the way that the church is described in the baptismal covenant, the third one in our hymnals. It says, "The church is of God and will be preserved to the end of time for the conduct of worship, the due administration of God's word and sacraments, the maintenance of Christian fellowship and discipline, the edification of believers, and the conversion of the world." All of us, of every stage, every age and station, stand in need of the means of grace which the church alone supplies. That gives such a great summary of what we're here for and what we're about. To hear God's word, to share in the sacraments, to be in fellowship with one another, to encourage one another, to support one another at all times in our lives, whether we're going through rough times or whether we're celebrating, to be there for one another as that body of Christ. The church isn't just a building. It is the ministry and the people that are gathered together to do the ministry which Christ has called us to do. When we act with integrity, we begin our work with humility and gentleness. We work our ministry in patience and always surrounded by love of one another. We have to do this with all integrity. There was a story that once Paul Harvey told about four young men who were late to class one day, and they entered their classroom, and they told their teacher very solemnly that they were detained due to a flat tire. And so the sympathetic teacher smiled and said, "Well, that was too bad because they were late and they'd missed a test that morning." However, she was willing to let them make it up. So she gave each of them a piece of paper and a pencil, and sent them to four corners of the room. And then she said they would pass if they could answer just one question: which tire was flat? I hope they had integrity on that day. I hope they had the integrity to talk to the teacher and tell her what was really true. You know, as we take a look, when we take stock in the church, this morning you have some cards in your bulletin. There's a blue one and a yellow one. The yellow one is for our annual stockholders dinner, which is going to be in 2 weeks. If you would let us know if you're going to be able to stay after that worship service and have dinner, because we do order this out and there's a cost to it. We cover that cost by having an auction, and we have a bunch of fun items that we'll sell at the auction, and that will cover the cost of the dinner. But if you're going to attend, please fill that out and you can hand that in. We would greatly appreciate that. When you're thinking about taking stock in the church, as we've talked about, I like to go back to what John Wesley would teach us. There's a sermon that he had that was on the use of money, and it's very simple. He gave us three ideas. He said, gain all that you can. Now, this is in good ways, because he also said, do no harm, do good for each other, and stay in love with God. So when you gain all you can, don't do it at the expense of someone else. Don't do it at the harm of someone else. Don't do it to the harm of yourself. In good, honest ways, make a living and gain all that you can. And he gave the second rule, and he said, save all you can. It's not a bad idea to put away for some for savings and make sure that you gain it and you save it. You use it wisely. And then he said, give all you can. Give all that you can, helping all the persons that you can, all the time that you can, and in every situation that you're able to do so. But you do first need to take care of yourselves. He didn't have any problem with that. Make sure that you're taken care of. Make sure that your family's taken care of. Make sure that you cover for your family's needs. and then find ways to give to the betterment of all. And especially, he said, take a look to the church. We're taking a look at some things this year, and I know that I saw the papers this last week, and it said that Beaver Dam's going to get a little bit of extra income from the state because half of our students, more than half of our students in school, are on free or reduced lunch. So we know that we're on the higher end of lower income in our community. And that is true. It's just a fact. It's the way we are, where we are, where we live, the jobs that are offered for persons in our community. That is a struggle that we have. We see that in the church. We know that happens. And we support one another in all ways that we can to take care of our families and our homes and ourselves. Then there's all these competing areas that want to know what can we do and how can we carry out the missions that we have or the projects that we have within our community, even in the churches. We look at that as a finance committee, even in the church, and we take close looks at it. We have watched over the last few years what we've ended up doing. We just want to give you a report a little bit. We have made a budget for the coming year based on the income that we've had during the last year, hoping that not everyone takes a drop in income. But that's the way we go about budgeting. We don't put something way out there and twist arms to try to make a budget. We use what you've actually given from the year before. And so we want to continue in those ways. This year, we're just a little bit behind where we've been before. And there's a couple things we want to be able to do to help. One, we know that if you're surrounded by debt, you're really not able to do much with that. I mean, bad debt is something that's not going to help any of us. There are a couple of offerings that we have, freed up from debt, or there's a longer class about financial success and how to get yourself out of debt. After the first of the year, if you're interested in that, because we truly do care about that, you can't help yourself, you can't help your family, your community, the church. You can't do that if you're underwater in debt. But how do you get out of it? And there are some good principles for that. We've got a couple of persons that are experts in the area of finance, and they can help you out with that. And we'd be glad to offer that class after the first of the year. So if you're interested in something like that, just jot your name down. You can be interested so that you might be able to help out a neighbor or a family member or one of your kids. And that's okay. You can still take it. You don't have to be surrounded in debt yourself in order to take that. You can help somebody else as you learn some of the basic core principles of that also. And so we do want to offer that. And if you're in that way, I don't expect to see you putting a lot down on a pledge card. I don't want somebody going into debt because you think, you know, we need more at the church. So don't put yourself in that situation. If you're not in that situation, if we had some persons that were able to increase, if we were able to give a little bit more, if you gave what you did this last year, and if we had about 20 to 25 persons increase, I call it by a quarter of a stock a year, that would be $250 per year. That would be enough for us to be able to hire another person to help out and assist us with our children's ministry and our youth ministry, to hire a coordinator to do those jobs. What I do see is it's been a little bit of a struggle over the last couple years with one pastor. I think we see some of the results of that. I love this place and love doing the work for all of you. I can't do the work that two people had done in the past. I just can't have that happen. So things do change a little bit. It has some impacts on us in our attendance and in our giving, but we need to ask for that extra help in some way or another. If you're able to do it financially, that's one thing, and so you can take a look at these stock cards on here, but on the back side, if you can't do anything more financially, here's the back side that takes a look at the gifts that you have, because it takes everything to make it work. If you're not able to increase or help out as much financially due to your situations, that's okay. Maybe you could help out in the area of Christian education. We could use a few more persons, especially in that area, to help us out, whether it's a teacher's assistance or helping with coordinate some of the projects or pulling materials together. That's one area that we know that we could always use a little more help. You could join the choir and sing for the Christmas cantata. That doesn't cost you much of anything. But it is a great time. It's a great group to be working with and singing with, and you get to pour out your heart to God. You don't have to put a lot in the offering plate to pour out your hearts and praises to God. You could find yourself offering and saying, I have a neighbor that I know has not experienced the love of Christ in the way that I have. And if you're willing to say, I'm going to be praying for that neighbor, and I want to find a way to invite them to church. I want to find a way to somehow share my faith in God, share my faith in Christ with them this coming year. If you commit yourself to do that, you can put that on the back here. See, I'm going to find a way that none of you have an excuse to not turn in a shareholder's card. That way you're all invited to the dinner. Every one of us has something that we can offer, because everyone is gifted by God. But remember when we started in the story and we took a look in Genesis that God created us, God's people, and when God looked at us, God said, this is very good. You are very good in God's eyes. And you have wonderful gifts that you're able to share. Some are able to share a bit more financially. And we thank God for those blessings. And those that can, we invite you to do so. Some of you aren't able to increase or maybe not even able to start. But you have other gifts that God's given to you. We need all of those gifts because we have a great ministry, a ministry of sharing Christ's love in this place and around the world. And we need all of us. We need all of us working together. So we invite you to consider how you would take stock in the church. If you could fill those out, and over the next couple of weeks, we'll give you a tally of those at our shareholders' dinner in 2 weeks. So we invite you to do that. Amen. Let's sing together one verse of the closing hymn, We've a Story to Tell to the Nations.
We've a story to tell to the nations that shall turn their hearts to the right. A story of truth and mercy, a story of peace and light. Story of peace and light, for the darkness shall turn to dawning, and the dawning to noonday bright. And Christ's great kingdom shall come on earth, a kingdom of love and light.
Gracious God, we have remembered those who have been in our lives, who have gone on before us and are now at rest in your realm. We have celebrated good stewardship within our church, the paying off of our bills, the work that we've had to improve our facilities and care for all that you have given to us. We've invited ourselves to take stock of all that you have given to us, the blessings that we have received individually, and how we want to share those back with you, our gifts, our time, our talent, the ways that we love you and how we can express ourselves. Send us forth in your name, filled with your grace and filled with your peace and your love. We ask this in Christ's name.